Welcome to this video, Azure Cost Management and Tagging, Part D, Reporting by Dimensions and Tags. This is the fourth part of this video series. My name is Terry Clancy. Azure Cost Management, or ACM, is a native Azure service designed to allow customers and partners to gain complete visibility and control of their cloud costs across Azure and Amazon Web Services, or AWS. By now, I assume you have seen the first three parts of this series. Part A, covering best practices around setting up your Azure environment to best support Azure systems and cost management. Part B, about setting up Azure entity hierarchies, which is a vital step to ensure a manageable environment that supports effective cost management. And Part C, discussing setting up secure access and settings. So, in this video, we will assume that your environment is all set up so we can focus on some practical tips about how to create useful reports. Azure Cost Management helps you make sense of what can be a very complex expenditure. For example, as you can see here, Azure has a great many infrastructure and platform services. Line of business applications can use complex combinations of these. Azure Cost Management makes it much easier to group and categorize spend by your specific applications, cost centers, or environments, as well as anything else that is helpful for your organization. To separate out costs in these ways, there are multiple approaches. First, let's discuss reporting by dimensions and attributes. You can set scope at any level of the hierarchy, including billing entities and resource entities. You can group by and filter on almost all of the billing and resource entities, with the notable exception at this time of management groups. The dimensions and attributes you will see in the Group By and Filter drop-down controls will vary by scope, as detailed on this page. So if a dimension you're expecting to see is not available in the Group By drop-down or in the Filter drop-down, then refer to this table and try changing your scope to one that offers that dimension. To view costs by a dimension or attribute, you always start by setting a scope that encompasses all the resources you want to include, and you can then filter on the built-in dimensions like resource, resource group, or subscription to select components used by your application, and then other components will then be excluded. Let's look how to do that in Azure Cost Management. Note that cost analysis is provided for the specific scope selected, so always use a scope pill at the top to ensure you are looking at the correct scope of interest. This is where you define what set of data you want to look at. Management and finance will typically focus on broader scopes, whereas app teams and developers will typically have a narrower focus, which might, for example, just be a small number of resource groups used by the application they are responsible for. On the main chart, you can group by any of the approximately 20 dimensions. For example, here I am grouping by the resource group name dimension. You can also group by subscription, resource, service name, meter, subscription, location, and more. This allows you to use grouping and filtering to drill down to report on costs just the way you want to. You can also filter by any dimension member by clicking on that member's color in any of the pie charts or in the larger chart above. When a filter is defined, it appears as a pill above, and if you click on the related X, you can remove it. The Add Filter pill is more powerful in that it allows you to multi-select dimension members to filter on. Let's now discuss multidimensional views. People often want to use these to extract data in the format required for multidimensional pivot tables in Excel, for example. To achieve this in Azure Cost Management, you should use tabular views and start with the two built-in tabular views, the Cost by Resource view and the Invoice Details view. For EA customers, the built-in Cost by Resource view provides a view of the multidimensional hierarchy from department down to enrollments, subscriptions, resource groups, and finally resources. The built-in Invoice Details view focuses on how costs are measured and provides a multidimensional hierarchy from meter category, which is equivalent to service name, down to meter subcategory, which is equivalent to service tier, down to meter. You can further customize these views to suit your needs. Once you have defined a view that meets your needs, you can export it as a CSV file for further analysis. For example, here we're using Microsoft Excel and defining a pivot table to allow us to filter and summarize data by any of the dimensions. If you need more dimensions than these reports allows for, you should use Azure Cost Management Exports. This exports multidimensional data into Azure Storage, but you should take into consideration that this will include all dimensions, which results in a large file with many columns and very many rows. The alternative to reporting costs by dimensions and attributes is to use tags. The management group hierarchy should be more focused on how you run Azure and on operational requirements. The billing entity hierarchy can be helpful, but will not always align to the way you want to aggregate and summarize costs, because you will normally want to summarize costs in different ways, which could never be satisfied by a single hierarchy. Tags fill this need. Suppose we wanted to aggregate costs for all apps related to HR, for example. These may be spread across the hierarchy as indicated by the red tag icons in this diagram. Now, if all those resources involved in those applications are tagged, then it's easy to group by them or filter them out so you can report on them in isolation. To do this, again, you start by setting your scope to a superset that includes all the resources you want to include. Then you apply custom tags to all the resources used by the application, and then you filter by them. Other resources will then be excluded. Let's look how to do that in Azure Cost Management. As with dimensions, you can also group costs by tags. Instead of a dimension, you select tag and then select the tag name or key of the tag you wish to group by. Similarly, you can filter by tags. Again, first select tag and then the tag name or key you wish to filter by, and then you can select the tag values you wish to include in the filter. With around 20 dimensions and the ability to add custom tags, Azure Cost Management is flexible enough that it should satisfy virtually all, if not all, your cloud cost reporting needs. As organizations move to the cloud, cost management is becoming more and more important. Azure Cost Management is designed to satisfy that need and ensure that Azure customers derive optimal value from the cloud. But this requires that governance and standards that we have discussed in this video series are put in place so that cost data is collected correctly and can be grouped and categorized and reported upon in a way that satisfies the needs of stakeholders and can drive optimization actions. Thanks for listening. Here are some links you may find helpful, and please see our other videos in the Azure Cost Management channel on YouTube using the link on this page. All the best with Azure Cost Management.